And let's get more details on that homecoming of Team Philippines from our correspondent Paige Javier. Paige, what more can you tell us?
Carmina, last-minute preparations are underway for the Heroes Grand Homecoming Parade for the Filipino athletes who competed at the Paris Olympics. Now, this parade was moved to August 14, Wednesday, from the initial date of Tuesday, a day after the arrival of Team Philippines. MNPA personnel were seen putting up more posters of the country's Olympians along the streets of Manila, which are part of the parade route on Tuesday morning. Now, we saw these personnel hanging up posters of Olympic bronze medalists Nesty Petesho and Ira Villegas, as well as posters of Team Philippines. Over the weekend, we saw them putting up posters of the country's golden boy, double Olympic gold medalist Carlos Yulo, alongside the posters which were put up by the city of Manila. Malacanang said the parade, which will begin at 3 p.m., will cover 7.7 kilometers. It will start at the Aliu Theater in Pasay and will end with a short program at Rizal Memorial Sports Complex in Manila. The MMDA advised motorists to take alternate routes to avoid heavy traffic, which will be expected in the area where the parade will happen. They released a list of these alternate routes on their social media pages, so they want the motorists to check these heavy traffic. But they are saying that they will implement a stop-and-go scheme in the vicinity of the parade, which they expect to last for 45 minutes. Carmina, back to you.
Thanks a lot, Paige Javier, there joining us on the line. House lawmaker Paolo Duterte has filed a bill that seeks mandatory drug tests on the president and all other government officials. Viv Engulia on the line now with that story. Viv, what more can you tell us?
Hi, Carmina. Davao City First District Representative Paolo Duterte has filed a bill seeking to mandate random drug tests on elected and appointed government officials, including the president. Under House Bill 10744, the random drug test will be conducted through hair follicle drug test, and if the individual tests positive, a confirmatory urine drug test will be conducted. According to the measure, any official found positive for use of dangerous drugs shall be dealt with administratively, which shall be a ground for suspension or termination from office, subject to certain pertinent laws. The bill, meanwhile, states that candidates for electoral posts may undergo voluntary hair follicle drug tests within 90 days prior to the elections. In his explanatory note, Duterte said that considering the initiatives towards the deterrence of drug use and abuse, exemptions or favors in the mandatory nature of random drug testing shall not extend to certain class privilege, such as the elected and appointed officials. He added that since it becomes imperative upon their own mandate that they shall lead the life of modesty and integrity, they should also be subject to random drug tests. For Kabataan Party List Representative Raul Manuel, the bill needs to be carefully studied, noting that the drug problem is a health problem and should not be used in any political agenda. He added that the proposal could violate individuals' right to privacy. Manuel considers the bill a disruption to the International Criminal Court investigation into the Duterte drug war. Last January, Representative Duterte's father, former President Rodrigo Duterte, had accused his successor of drug use, and President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. had said that the verbal attacks against him could have been prompted by the alleged use of a powerful opioid painkiller, adding that he did not want to dignify the accusation. Former President Duterte later denied calling Marcos Jr. a drug addict. And according to the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency, Marcos Jr. has never been on the drug watch list. Carmina, back to you.
All right, Viv. You know, there is some sense to the bill that is being proposed. But the fact that he's the one who's proposing it, the same guy who's being linked to drug smuggling, is it getting any support from his colleagues? They're considering as well that there seems to be a line that's now dividing those who are supportive of the president and those supportive of the former president, Rodrigo Duterte. Having said that, Viv, is this bill getting enough support from his colleagues? What's the sense you're getting?
Well, according to our interview with some lawmakers, junior lawmakers here at the House of Representatives, they are saying that they are open to supporting the bill, but that it should be applied fairly, and it should not only include government officials or elected or appointed government officials, but should also include or cover officials and personnel in local government units, so that it could be applied fairly. But then it should. They are also questioning if it is related to the Supreme Court case, which deemed unconstitutional the mandatory drug test on candidates for public office, which essentially makes the drug test a qualification for candidacy. So these issues they will have to discuss during the committee deliberations on the said bill, which the lawmakers hope Representative Duterte will attend and be able to defend his proposal. Carmina.
All right, thanks a lot. Vivian Gulia there, joining us on the line. The Philippine Court of Appeals refuses to give a protection order to two environmental activists who claim they were abducted by the military. Jed Tamano and Jonila Castro's petition for a writ of amparo was denied, with the appellate court ruling they were not under threat when they were detained in a military camp last year. It also found no proof the two were still receiving threats after their release. National Security Council Assistant Director General Jonathan Malaya welcomes the court's decision. He asserts the activists have nothing to fear.
There's nothing for them to fear because first and foremost, the Supreme Court, the Court of Appeals itself said that there is no imminent or continuing threat to their life, liberty, and security. In fact, I've seen Jed and Jonila come on ANC. Okay, I see them in protests and demonstrations all over the Philippines. Whenever there's a big issue, they're there. And they even went to the Netherlands to speak at a public forum. So the Court of Appeals saw through this, no, through all of the propaganda, and saw that they are exercising their full freedom. We were the ones harassed by all of these cases that they filed against us. We cannot be judged for the actions of the previous NTF-LCAC leadership. This is a different NTF-LCAC.